Nearly 100 residents turned out to hear how candidates for both the city council and mayor would fix a number of issues Morro Bay is dealing with. KSBY News reporter Dustin Kleeman was there and had what candidates had to say. Dustin?
Good evening, Richard. Candidates did point out the division among residents on these issues, but tonight they all agreed there is common ground for them to find and move the town forward.
Thank you, Erica. Not necessary.
Residents heard from seven candidates Monday night to help them decide who to vote for in November. Candidates discussed their views on the current financial state of Morro Bay, improvements to the Embarcadero, and the proposed sewer project, including the water reclamation facility. Both mayoral candidates support it.
The city has spent an inordinate amount of time examining alternatives. And I must say, in my opinion, there is absolutely no ideal project.
I would look to lower cost and look at the water reclamation component of the project and the viability of that water being put where it's planned.
Another topic of discussion, vacation rentals. Both Heading and Weiss said the issue needs to be reexamined and fixed.
If the permits are not active after a year, then they should not continue to be permittees, and the number will go down. In terms of proximity to one another is another issue that has to be looked at, and we must have a buffer zone.
I would like to see input from the community, and I would like to see it work both ways. It is an avenue of revenue that is growing, but sadly, our hotel revenue is suffering, and so we need to have a tourism plan in place where both are growing together.
All candidates stress the importance of unifying the fractured community.
We have divided the town because we have an us versus them mentality, and I would like to bring us together so that we are in agreement, working together, because we all love Morro Bay.
We've got to get over this polarization that has occurred because there's so much to do.
All the candidates tonight, all seven, supported investigating ways to look into more opportunities on renewable wind energy. If you missed the forum, don't worry, you can tune into Channel 20. That's Slow Span. Live in the newsroom, I'm Dustin Kleeman, KSBY News.
All right, Dustin, thank you. The forum was hosted by the League of Women Voters.